welcome my sister, Lili Popka, who is at Michigan. Studying music performance for the clarinet and psychology. So just to give a background on this quintet. So this quintet came to be because of the friendship between Carl Maria von Weber and Heinrich Barma. A clarinet virtuoso of the time has been described as one of the most productive, important relationships in the history of the clarinet. In the early 19th century, Barman was famous in Europe as the leading clarinet virtuoso, and met Weber and counseled Weber on musical and technical possibilities he could achieve on his advanced Riesling and Schlock 10-key clarinet. I assume Lili knows what that means. Weber, known in music history as the father of romantic opera, was a magnificent melodist and orchestrator, very adept at composing vocal music. The unique combination of Weber's melodic gifts combined with Barman's virtuosity produced some of the greatest works ever written for the clarinet. After the resounding successes of the concertina Opus 26 and two concertos Opus 73 and 74 in 1811, the Weber-Barman collaboration has forever been etched in music history. In 1815, Weber composed what we'll be playing in the first movement of today, the Grand Quintet, Opus 34 for Barman and the String Quartet. The quartet is commonly referred to as the Barman Quintet. It is both possible and likely that Weber was familiar with the masterwork of, I bet you've never heard of this guy, Mozart, written in 1789 for the same instrumental combination. So aside from the special gifts of each composer, that what mainly differentiates this from the Mozart Clarinet Quintet, which is also very famous, is the musical style and intent. So Mozart's four-movement masterpiece is a true chamber music work. So each of the string quartet's instruments complement the clarinet, often as equal voices, thus creating a musical mosaic of blended textures. Weber's work, on the other hand, is essentially a clarinet concerto, which basically means she's going to be doing a lot of fast notes and very impressive stuff while we accompany her. Also composed in the four movements, the Grand Quintet is full of virtuosic technical vocal passages for the soloist. So, the Grand Quintet is often neglected as string players generally prefer to perform the clarinet quintets of Mozart and Brahms, who actually just proposed that. We're all like neighbors and all we want to do. So we passed up Mozart and Brahms. The Grand Quintet is sometimes performed as a true concerto with a full orchestra. So that's pretty cool. And then overall, the Grand Quintet is a monument in the clarinet repertoire, and I hope that you enjoy our rendition of the first movement.